So in this section, we're going to learn about sputtering using the Orion system. So we're going to just pretend that we came to the system and it's idle, which is how you would leave it if you were to leave for the day. So just like with evaporation, you check the four things that you need to check every single time you use the Orion, which is you check the water, the power, the gas, and you also check the vacuum. So number one, going to the power, we're checking the power. The chiller is on. The process variable and the set variable are the same, which means that it is pumping the water at the temperature that it's saying that it's pumping. Check the vacuum. Main chamber is 74 nanotor. That's really good. The load lock chamber is 96 nanotor. So that's really, really good. Those are ideal pressures. And now we check the power. System itself is on. But let's turn on the sputter power, which is down here. This is the DC power supply for the sputter. Just a little footnote, there's two types of sputtering. DC and then RF, which is basically AC at an RF frequency. DC is for conductive targets like gold, silver, platinum, palladium. RF is for sputtering insulators like silica, aluminum oxide, and other materials that don't conduct electricity very well. And the reason why you need RF is because if you use a DC power supply, the charge will build up behind the insulated target and that will heat it up and cause it to melt. So our system only does DC for now. So this is a DC power supply. So let's go ahead and go forward with turning it on. All you gotta do is just flip the switch. And then now we go to the fourth thing, which is the gas. So with the evaporation mode, all you need to do is just turn on the nitrogen right here. But with sputtering, you need an additional gas. You need the actual source gas for the plasma. With sputtering, you need to basically feed a gas into the chamber, and then using the gun, you light that gas into a plasma, and then that plasma will be driven by magnets onto the target, and then the target will eject material, and that's how the metal is deposited onto the substrate, by that gas turning into a plasma and then impacting onto the target, and then the target ejects material off. So the gas that we use for the Orion is argon. And the argon tank is back here, and you can see that it's off. So we'll go ahead and turn it on. Pressure is about 10 PSI. We want it between 8 and 10 PSI because that's the mass flow controllers can only take that much pressure. If you put it any higher, that could damage them. And then here's the nitrogen. It's left open to the atmosphere like it is every night. So when you come in, you go ahead and you turn the nitrogen on. You want to burp all that air out of the line right here. You do that. Let it go for a couple seconds. And then close it. Turn that up all the way. And then now your nitrogen is on. Okay. So we're going to skip the process of loading the substrate. But we're just going to pretend that a substrate is already in there. And we'll just go with the transferring and the subsequent sputtering. So just to recap, if you were to vent it, all you would do is just turn the vent switch off for the load lock, and then you could just load your sample on. But let's pretend that it's already in there. All right, so now we're gonna open up the chamber. Open up the gate. Open this up, turn the lights on so we can see that how we're transferring. You see the shutter is in the way. So let's move the shutter out of the way and start transferring. See, only two fingers, and then put that in there. And you see that the little one of the clips is kind of hanging off there. That's a no-no, but we'll just deal with that for now. Last person to load it.
didn't tighten the clips. So let's pretend that that isn't a problem. And then putting the stage down, rotating it and pulling that back up. And then we're gonna go ahead and pull this back. And now our stage is successfully mounted in there. Okay. All right, so next step is you wanna close the turbo gate. Basically the gate that separates the turbo from the main chamber, and it's back there. You see where the laser is? So you wanna turn it to right here where this line is. And what that's gonna do is that's gonna close the gate, and then you leave it right here so that it's hanging, just being held up by its own weight right there. And you can see now the gate is closed back there. Pretty much closed. Not fully closed, but almost fully closed. And the reason for that is it's a lot easier to control the pressure with the mass flow controller when the turbo is sectioned off a little bit. Basically, the turbo is so strong, any gas that you put in, any argon gas that we put in with the mass flow controller, is gonna instantly get sucked up. So it's gonna be hard to get a stable pressure with the turbo all the way open and exposed. So we close it a little bit so we have more control over the chamber pressure. So now the anti-chamber, the load lock chamber, and the main chamber are still open to each other. So let's close that now that we pulled the load lock all the way back. And you see the pressure is starting to go up because our turbo is closed. So, and we don't have the assistance of this turbo right here because these chambers are closed off from each other. And let's turn on the gas. So right now it's at 12 standard cubic centimeters per minute. So let's turn the argon on. And you see that this is the actual flow that it's measuring. And you see the pressure spiked up. Okay? All right, and now it's stabilizing, and now it's about 10 millitorr. What it's stabilized at. So now let's turn the lights off. And close the windows because we're going to spark a plasma now. And essentially, what you want to do is you want to let the chamber fill up with argon. We just turned it on right now. You want to let the chamber fill up with argon for a second because that argon needs to basically come into contact with the target right there in order for the plasma to be lit. So we're letting the chamber kind of fill up with argon for a second, so that way the argon can get equally distributed and within the chamber, because it's necessary to actually arc that plasma. And it's very, very low pressure, so it takes a while for it to become equally distributed within the entire chamber. I said distributed, don't know why I said that, but let's ignore that. Okay, so now we waited a couple seconds. So let's keep this window open since the shutter is closed for the gun back here. When we arc it, we're not gonna get any deposition, but we're gonna close this window when we actually open up that shutter on top of the gun and start sputtering. Okay, so let's look at the scoreboard. We have gun one and gun two. Gun one has aluminum, gun two has silver. That's gun one back there. And then this is gun two right there. Okay, so let's fire up gun one. Okay. And then this is the power source. With the dial, you can control whatever gun you want on here. We have, this power supply is able to take four guns. We only have two. So we're gonna do gun one. We're gonna click on that. And then we're gonna set the wattage. We always start off at 50 to ignite our plasma. And then you can control that with the dial. And then you push, once you select that, you click the dial. And then you go back to the number. You click again. You go back to the number and you make sure that it's flashing. So now you've set the wattage with the power supply and you have the number one flashing. Once the number of the gun is flashing, you could then turn it on. If it's not flashing, you cannot turn it on. And the way you do that, say if I want to use gun two, you just move it with the dial. And then if you want to change parameters for gun two, like the power, you just click, and then that allows you to actually change parameters. You always adjust the wattage, and you click again, select it by, and then once you reach the power you want to use, you click it, click again, whoops, click it. Sorry, click it again, move up to gun, click on gun, and then now you're ready to power it. All right, so now that we're on one and one is flashing, you can push on and you see plasma light up. That means the plasma is on. If it says arc, that's a bad thing. If it says plasma fail, that is also a bad thing. But you can see that it's actually reading the 50 watts that we want to put into there. So let's go and look and see if the plasma is on. You can see the light from the plasma back there through the little hole. Let's open her up really quick. There we go. Beautiful plasma right there. So now that we are, now that we fired up that plasma, we could change the power by pushing the dial and we could put it up to 100. Let's start sputtering at 100 watts. Okay. And you can see the color slightly changes when you do that. All right. And the more power you put onto the sputter gun, the faster it's going to sputter. The more gas you put into the chamber, the faster it's going to sputter also, because it's going to have more gas molecules to turn into a plasma and then impact onto the target. The uniformity will be different though if you increase the gas pressure though, because the mean free path of the gases is going to decrease, you'll get more non-uniform coverage on your substrate. So that's kind of what you lose by increasing the pressure. You get faster sputter, but you get more non-uniform coverage. So we're gonna basically measure a recipe for silver right now. And the cool thing about sputtering is if you use the same pressure, same target, and keep all parameters constant, you will get the same rate every single time if you keep the pressure and the power constant. So once again, there are two things that you need for a recipe. And a recipe is like basically your metal deposition rate. There are two things you need for a recipe, the pressure and the power. So right now, our pressure is 9.7 millitor. Okay, and then our power at the target is 99 watts, okay? So now we're gonna check the rate that we get at 99 watts and 9.7 millitor. The way that we're gonna do that is we're gonna get the QCM and move it right there, right next to the target, or I'm sorry, the substrate shutter. We're gonna move the QCM into the position, and then we're gonna measure the rate with the QCM. All right, so with the deposition controller, there is, we're gonna reset it. There is one process for sputtering, and we use this for all types of sputtering. We're gonna select that, and we're gonna edit it to find out what material is in there right now. So right now, aluminum sputtering is in there. So the last person who sputtered was measuring aluminum and trying to get the rate for aluminum. So we're going to delete that because we want silver, and we're going to insert new, and we're going to look for silver sputter. This is silver evaporation right here, and we want silver sputter, and that's right there. Insert that one. Going to edit it. All right, and now that we're editing it, we want the final thickness to be something high, because if the thickness that it measures is too low, it will shut the whole system off. So we want that to be something really high. Enter that. I put 114 nanometers. And then we also want to turn the QCM on. That's sensor one. There's two sensors for two QCMs. We only have one QCM, so we want to turn that on. We click that, press enter. Start mode, manual, we want to keep that. And then everything else we don't need to worry about. Go to main, press start, and press start layer. And then on top, you see that sputter recipe is, the sputter recipe is in there. Okay? All right, so now we're gonna measure our rate. So we're gonna open our shutter right here. And now we're going to see the rate that we get. Right now we're not getting any rate. It's kind of weird. Because we should get some kind of rate. So let's go ahead. Oh, we're getting a rate of about 0.1 angstroms. Actually, gun one is aluminum, not silver. So this is good. I made a mistake. We're going to change it. Stop the layer, quick edit it, we're gonna remove the silver and put aluminum in there. That's why it wasn't measuring any rate, because we're depositing aluminum atoms onto something that was supposed to be measuring silver. We told it to measure silver, so delete that, insert new. So it was a great learning experience. So we were right by putting aluminum on there, or having aluminum on there initially, but this is good because now we get to go through the process of changing it. Gonna insert silver sputtering, edit it, make the final thickness something really high, enter that, turn that QCM on, go to main, start it, and now we're starting it again. And let's actually go higher on our power. Let's go all the way up to 150. And you see the color is changing for aluminum. And then there's our rate. 0.67, about 0.67, 0.68 angstroms per second. Okay, so now we have our recipe. We get 0.67 angstroms per second with a pressure of 9.9 millitorr and 149 watts. So then we would write down our recipe. And our recipe for silver, for aluminum will be 0.67 angstroms per second at 150 watts and 9.9 millitorr. So over the course of time, you'll develop a ton of recipes depending on what you're working with, but that's how you come up with a recipe, and that's how you use the QCM. So let's go ahead and stop that, and let's end our process right now. We're stopping the QCM. Let's close that shutter right there. Gun shutter's closed. Turn on the lights. let's move the QCM back. And you can see plasma is still lit. So we're gonna gradually power it down, back down to 50, and then we'll turn it off. There it is, back down to 50. And then turn that bad boy off. Now the plasma's off. Check to make sure it's off. It is. And then we turn off our gas. Turn that off, and you see the pressure's rising. And then let's open up the chamber. I'm sorry, the gate for the turbo. Open that bad boy up right here. And then you see the pressure decreasing because now the turbo is opened up to the main chamber. And now we can transfer our substrate out. Open up the load lock gate. And then see those pins, when they're loose like that, it makes it hard to actually transfer the stage back onto it because it's blocking everything. But I did it very easily because I practically built the system and it's me. So not that hard for me, but I guarantee it will be hard for people who are first using the instrument to dodge that all kind of, to dodge that stuff. So then you pull it back right here, and then you can see substrate stage is in its home in the load lock, and then you close it off. Everything in here is fine. Close that off, turn the lights off. And right now, at this point, you would vent it. You would vent the actual load lock. Now that this is closed, you can vent the load lock and retrieve your substrate. But we'll just leave it as is, since there is no substrate in there. So then you would go and you would do the four things in reverse. The four main things that you check with the Orion: the power, gas, vacuum, and power, gas, vacuum, and the water. So let's do the power first. Your sputtering power source is still on. Turn that bad boy off. Gas, we don't need the argon anymore, so let's close it off with this, the downstream valve first, and then the main valve second. Nitrogen, same thing. Remember, nitrogen is the venting gas. And then also, you want to leave it open to air. So that way, if this thing turns off in the middle of the night, it won't suck up oil from the vacuum. It'll just suck up air from 214. So now that's open. That's standard policy for using the Orion. That is the standard policy for shutdowns. To open the nitrogen tank up to air, so that way you're not... the nitrogen tank is closed and you're not wasting nitrogen, but then also if the chamber, if the system shuts down in the middle of the night, you don't actually pull, since there's no nitrogen to pull, it'll pull up oil into the turbos, and this is so that you don't do that. So it's important that you open it up to atmosphere. And then you check the water. The water's fine. And then lastly, you check the vacuums. 4.9 minus 8, and then 2.8 minus 7. That's pretty good. Got a little dirty when we were writing it. You know, with sputtering, that should fix itself within a couple hours. And then that's it. That's pretty much sputtering. This training covered how to actually use a sputter and how to measure a recipe. So in the next video, we'll talk about more technical parts of the instrument, like changing targets and whatnot. But that's it. Thanks for listening.